Good morning, friends. Today we are going to discuss our chapter triangles, chapter number 7 of the class 9th, exercise 7.2. Before starting the exercise, first of all, we discuss about the basic concepts which we will use in this exercise. There are two basic concepts we have to use. They are vice versa to each other. First is, if the opposite sides opposite to equal angles are equal, means in this triangle, if the angles B and angle C is equal, it implies that AB will equals to AC. Side opposite to equal angles, so this angle ke opposite this side and angle side opposite to this angle will be AC, that is why AB is equals to AC. Similarly, the vice versa is angle opposite to equal sides are equal. Means if the side AB and AC are equal, then opposite angle of these sides are B and C, which will be equal. Now we are going to discuss the exercise 7.2, question number 1. Let us start. So this is our first question, question number 1, which is given as triangle A. In triangle ABC, AB is equals to AC. It is given that AB is equals to AC and OB and OC bisect by angles bisect the angle B and C, means OB bisect angle B. It means this part will equals to this one and this part is equals to this one, and we have joined OA also. We have to prove that OB is equals to OC and OA bisect angle A. It's a very simple question. First of all, we will say, since AB is equals to AC, it means angle ABC will equals to angle ACB. Our criteria of angle opposite equal sides are equal. Since the angles are equal, so their half will also equal. So half of angle ABC will equals to half of angle ACB. It means half of angle B is angle OBC. It means angle OBC is equals to angle OCB. And again, the vice versa of this property, we can say if these angles are equal, it means sides are equal, it means OB is equals to OC. By the criteria of sides opposite equal angles are equal, now the second part of the, to prove that OA bisect angle A, we can take the triangle this one and this one, means in triangle AOB and triangle AOC, in these two triangles AB is equals to AC, it is given. Similarly, OA is equals to OA, it is a common part, and OB is equals to OC, we have proved just now, we have already proved it. That is why triangle AOB will congruent to triangle AOC by side criteria of the congruency. If the triangle are congruent, means their angle will equals, it means angle OAB will equals to angle OAC by the CPCT, corresponding part of congruent triangles. If the angles, these angles are equal, it means, it implies that OA bisect angle A and the second part is proved. I hope you understand the solution. Now we'll discuss the question number 2. Here is the question number 2. It is given in a triangle ABC, AD is the perpendicular bisector of BC. Perpendicular and bisector. That is why I write here AD is perpendicular to BC means perpendicular and BD is close to DC means bisected. Clear? We have to prove that ABC is an isosceles triangle. Isosceles means two side equals. So I have to prove AB is equals to AC. Simple question. The solution is, as AD is a perpendicular bisector, there are two triangles I can see. In triangle ADB and triangle ADC, in the both of these triangles, we can easily see the three things which are equals. Three parts are BD is equals to DC as it is given. Second, AD is equals to AD, which is a common part of both the triangles, and angle ADB is equals to angle ADC, each 90 degree, because it is a perpendicular, so both angles will be 90. So as you can see, the three things are equals. It means triangle ADB will congruent to triangle ADC. Which criteria is there? There are two sides and angle between them. It means it is a SAS congruency. If the triangles are congruent, then the corresponding parts are equal. It means the side AB will equals to side AC by the CPCT. If the two sides are equal, it means triangle ABC is isosceles. Hence proved. Now the question number 3. So there is the question number 3. It is given that triangle ABC is isosceles. Isosceles means two sides are equal, and in the question it is given that AB is equals to AC. That is why I say it is isosceles. BE and CF are the perpendiculars. You can see in the diagram. We have to prove these altitudes, which are known as the perpendiculars, are equal. Means we have to prove BE is equals to CF. Again, simple question. In triangle, first of all, triangle से पहले हम लेंगे in triangle ABC. Since AB is equals to AC, as it is given, so angle ABC will equals to angle ACB. If these two sides are equal, it means these two angles will also equal. By the criteria, angles opposite equal sides are equal. Now in triangle BCE and triangle BCF, you can see here this triangle BCE and BCF. First of all, I draw the BCF. And this is the BCE. In these two triangles, what is the common things is, first of all, angle E is equals to angle F, 90 degree each. Second, BC is equals to BC, which is a common part. And the third thing, this angle CBF will equals to angle BCE, because AB is equals to AC, as I write here. Here I write CBF. When I say CBF, you can say CBF or CBA या ABC. Means same है. तो ये angle और ये angle बिल्कुल equal है. Same चीज. बस the vertex जो है वो A की बजाय मैंने C ले लिया है. Hence, because the two triangles are congruent, तो triangle BCE is congruent to triangle BCF by the criteria of there are two angles and a side, and these two angles are different. So AAS. Why I don't use here ASA? Because these two angles not include the equal sides BF is equal to CE. It is not given. The side is this one. That is why I used AAS. Since the triangle are congruent, the corresponding part are equals. It means BE is equals to C of F, CF by the CP, CT. Hence proved. Now the next question. So students, question number 4 is there. It is just opposite to the question number 3. Here it is given that triangle ABC, BE is equals to CF, these two altitudes are equal. It has been given now. We have to prove triangle ABE and ACF are congruent. Upper triangles ABE and ACF, these upper triangles are equal, and the sides AB is equals to AC. Means triangle ABC is isosceles, we have to prove. First of all, these two triangles have to congruent. So I can say in triangle ABE and triangle ACF, in these two triangles, the first thing is BE is equals to CF as it is given. Second, angle E is equals to angle F, 90 degree each. What about the third thing? You can see in both the triangles, angle A is a common part. So I can say angle A is equals to angle A, which is a common. Again, since the two angles and a side is equals, therefore triangle ABE will congruent to triangle ACF by angle side. Again, the two angles are not include the common side, that is why. Since the triangle are congruent, so by CPCT AB is equals to AC by CPCT, and since AB is equals to AC, it means triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle, and has proved. Now we will discuss question number 5. So here the question number 5. It is given that triangle ABC and DBC are isosceles such that AB is close to AC and BD is close to CD, as I write here. We have to prove angle ABD, this full angle, will equals to ACD. This question can be done by two ways. I will show you both the ways. First of all, the basic thing is solution. Since AB is equals to AC in this triangle, this side is equals to this side. It means this angle, let's suppose it is 1 and this is number 2. It means angle 1 is equals to angle 2 by the reason of angle opposite equal sides are equal. Similarly, in the triangle BDC, BD, DB you can say, is equals to DC. It means angle 3 will equals to angle 4. Again, by the same reason, that is why I don't write it again. Now, if we add, then I will get angle 1 plus angle 3 will equals to angle 2 plus angle 4, and angle 1 plus 3 means angle ABD. So it is angle ABD will equals to angle ACD. Hence proved. There is another way to solve this question. If I construct here, join OA, AD, sorry. If I join AD, then in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, AB is equals to AC, it is given. Similarly, BD, DB is equals to DC, it is also given. And AD is equals to AD is a common part. It means triangle ABD will congruent to triangle ACD by SSS congruency, which I have already discussed in my first lecture. Since the triangles are congruent, so by CPCT, angle ABD will equals to angle ACD by the CPCT criteria. This is the another way to solve this question. So it is upon you which criteria you will going to use. Both are equal and both are valid. So friends, there is a question number 6 now. It is given that triangle ABC is isosceles such that AB is close to AC, and then BA is extended such that AD is also equals to AB. We have to prove that angle BCD is right angle. Right angle means 90 degree. We have to prove it. Very simple question it is. Now the solution is, since AB is equals to AC, which is equals to AD. Now, AB is equals to AC, it means this angle will equals to this. It means angle 1 will equals to angle 2. Again, the reason, angle opposite equal sides are equal. Similarly, since AC is also equals to AD, it means angle 3 will equals to angle 4, because these two sides are equal, means angles are equal. So angle 3 will equals to angle 4, again by the same reason. Now, if we just add in triangle, whole triangle DBC, we can say angle 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 will make 180 degree. As you know, angle sum property we have read in chapter number 6. Of triangle. Now we have to prove BCD. In this BCD, angle 2 and angle 3 are involved. So where basic need is angle 2 and angle 3, not angle 1, not angle 4. So we should have changed it by these two reasons. So I can say angle 1 can be written as angle number 2, angle 2 as it is. angle 4 can be written as angle 3 is equals to 180. You can say that by the reason of 1 and 2. It is twice of angle 2 plus twice of angle 3 is equals to 180. 2 is the common. Angle 2 plus angle 3 is equals to 180. It means angle 2 plus angle 3. Angle 2 plus angle 3 will make angle BCD is equals to 180. This 2 will come in the denominator and cancel out 90 degree. Hence proved. It means angle BCD is 90 degree. Or you can say BCD is a right angle. Now question number 7 now. Here is the question number 7. In this triangle, it is given that triangle ABC right angle at A means angle A is 90 degree and the two sides AB is equals to AC. As I has already I written here. We have to find the value of angle B and angle C. It is again a very simple question. We can say in triangle ABC, AB is equals to given as AC. These two sides are equal. Then angle opposite to this side is this and this side is this. It means angle B will equals to angle C by the reason of angles opposite equal sides are equal. Now these triangles are equals, therefore you can say angle A plus angle B plus angle C should be equals to 180 by angle sum property. Of the triangle, angle A is 90 degree, B and C are equal, so I can write it is as angle B, and C can also be written as angle B because angle B is equals to angle C. So it means twice of angle B is equals to 180 minus 90. This 90 will go this side. Twice of angle B is equals to 90 degree, or angle B is equals to 90 by 2, you can say 45. Since B and C are equal, that is my angle C will also equals to 45 degree. So we can say angle B is 45, angle C is also 45. So students, there is another question, last question of the exercise 7.2. It is given that, given is equilateral triangle. I have made an equilateral triangle ABC. You know what is equilateral triangle, whose all three sides are equal. So we can say AB is equals to BC is equals to AC. We have to prove that angle of equilateral triangle is 60 degree. Means each angle of this ABC is 60. Very simple question it is. Since triangle ABC is equilateral, therefore side AB will equals to BC will equals to the side AC also. Now see here, as I say AB is equals to BC. If AB is equals to BC, means this angle will equals to this. It means angle A will equals to angle C. And now BC is equals to AC. BC and AC are equal. It means angle A will also equals to angle B. So it will also equals to angle B. Angle A is also equals to angle B. Now in triangle ABC, angle A plus angle B plus angle C should be equals to 180 by angle sum property of triangle. Since A, B, C are all equals, so I can write angle A plus angle A plus angle A, because B is also equals to A and C is also equals to A. It means thrice of angle A is equals to 180. It means angle A is equals to 180 by 3 or 60. Since all the angles are equals, so it is all the angles are 60 degree each. So there is the end of the exercise 7.2. In our next lecture, we will discuss exercise 7.3. Till then, practice it. Bye.